Okay, so, ready to have your mind blown? We're diving into some seriously next-level HIV research today. We're talking about the kind of stuff that could change how we think about HIV treatment forever.
It's a big deal.
Yeah.
This research is really pushing boundaries, offering hope, where, frankly, we haven't had a lot.
And that's what's so wild to me. You know, it's not just about making existing treatments a little bit better. This is like a whole new playbook for dealing with HIV. I mean, we've got ART, antiretroviral therapy, which has been huge. Obviously, it's saved countless lives, but it's not a cure, right? You have to take those meds every single day, and HIV is still lurking in the background.
Exactly. And that's where those pesky viral reservoirs come in. They're like these hidden bunkers where HIV can hide out, even from the toughest medications. It's one of the biggest roadblocks to a cure, for sure.
So it's kind of like, you know, when you have weeds in your garden, you pull them up, but those roots are still down there just waiting to sprout again. And that's what scientists have been wrestling with. How do you get to those sneaky viral reservoirs?
And so far, the strategies have been, well, kind of intense. You've got the shock and kill method, which is like try to flush the virus out so you can nuke it.
Yeah.
Or you've got block and lock, which is more about containment, keeping the virus suppressed.
All right, right. Those are the usual suspects. But this new research, this is where it gets really cool. Professor Yuntao Wu at George Mason University, they're doing something totally different. They've created this, get this, an HIV-like particle.
Yeah.
And before you freak out, no, it doesn't give you HIV.
You know, it's not about attacking the virus head on. That's what's so clever here. Think of it more like a Trojan horse, you know. Sneaking in and changing the whole game.
Okay, love that analogy. So what's inside this Trojan horse? What's the secret weapon?
Therapeutic genes. But these genes aren't meant to destroy the reservoirs. They're designed to reprogram them.
Wait, hold up. Reprogram infected cells? Like, turn them into the good guys.
You got it. We're talking about transforming those infected cells, those reservoirs, into mini vaccine factories.
Mini vaccine factories. Okay, now you have to explain that one. How does that even work?
So there's this protein in HIV called Rev. It's like a key, a homing beacon that lets the particles zero in on those viral reservoirs.
So this particle has like a VIP pass. It can just waltz right in and deliver those genes.
Exactly. And get this, not just about shrinking those reservoirs. This method actually gives the immune system a boost, helps it fight HIV better on its own.
Whoa, a two-for-one deal. Shrinking the viral hideouts and giving the immune system an upgrade at the same time, that's seriously impressive. Okay, so it's like, we're not just winning the battle, we're converting the enemy to our side, huh?
Exactly. And the best part is, this isn't just some sci-fi fantasy. They've actually tested this in monkeys, you know, with SIV. It's basically the monkey version of HIV.
Mm-hmm.
And the results are, well, they're pretty mind-blowing. One monkey, get this, had no detectable virus.
Yeah.
Not just in their blood, but in their brain too, which is like notoriously hard to reach. And this was after they stopped RT completely for over 2 years.
2 years? Are you kidding me? That's unheard of with what we have now. We're talking to like potentially freeing people from those daily pills, the side effects, the whole nine yards. This could be life-changing stuff.
No doubt. It could change everything. It really hints at a future where maybe, just maybe, HIV isn't this chronic thing anymore. Maybe it's something we can actually cure, or at least manage without, you know, turning people's lives upside down.
So no more daily pill reminders, no more constant worry in the back of your mind. It sounds like we're on the verge of something truly revolutionary here.
It's definitely a big step, but got to add a little dose of reality here. This is still early days, you know.
Mm-hmm.
We need more research, bigger studies, and then, of course, the whole human trials thing. Professor Wu himself said it took 20 years to get to this point. So got to manage those expectations a bit.
Right, right. Got to temper the excitement with a little patience. But still, even the possibility, I mean, what you're describing is huge. It's like rewriting the rules on how we treat HIV.
It's a potential game changer, no doubt. And the ripple effects. Wow. Think about it. It's not just about individual lives, although that's obviously the priority. But this could impact, like, global health, slow down the spread of HIV, maybe even change how healthcare systems use their resources. The possibilities are kind of endless.
Okay, so we've talked about these crazy cool HIV-like particles, the Trojan horse thing, delivering those therapeutic genes. But let's get into the nitty-gritty, the how. You mentioned mini vaccine factories.
Mm-hmm.
What's actually going on inside those reprogrammed cells? Paint me a picture.
Okay, so picture this. Your immune system, right? And specifically, these cells called T cells, they're like the elite forces of your body's defense system, trained to seek and destroy invaders, like viruses.
Right, like our own personal bodyguard squad, except their target is anything that wants to make us sick.
Exactly. But here's the thing. HIV, it's sneaky. It actually targets those T cells. It weakens the very system that's supposed to fight it off, which is why people with the HIV, they're more vulnerable to other infections, too. Their defenses are down.
It's like HIV disarms the security system before breaking in. That's messed up.
Exactly. But now imagine this. What if we could not only fix that security system, but upgrade it? What if we could give it a detailed map of HIV, train it to be even more effective?
Okay, now you're talking my language. How do we go from disarmed to superpowered immune system? How does this therapy actually reprogram things?
Okay, so remember those therapeutic genes, the ones our Trojan horse particle is delivering? Well, those genes, they carry a whole new set of instructions for those infected cells. Instead of churning out more virus, those reprogrammed cells, they start producing proteins that actually boost the immune system. It's like strengthening our defenses from the inside out.
So we're taking those infected cells, those former enemy combatants, and we're turning them into double agents. That's genius.
It's pretty amazing, right? And it gets even better. These reprogrammed cells, they can actually teach other immune cells how to recognize and fight HIV. It's like creating a whole army of highly trained specialists, all dedicated to wiping out the virus.
Whoa. So this isn't just about suppressing HIV. It's about giving the body the tools to fight back on its own. This is incredible stuff, but I have to imagine, with any new medical technology, there are always challenges.
Oh, absolutely.
What kind of hurdles do you think researchers might face as they move forward with this therapy?
So we're basically giving our immune system a crash course in, like, advanced HIV combat, huh?
Yeah, that's a good way to put it.
Pretty amazing stuff. But I gotta imagine, with any kind of new medical tech, there are always going to be some bumps in the road, you know? What are some of the big what-ifs researchers are going to have to tackle as they keep digging into this? You're thinking about it the right way, for sure. Every big scientific leap forward, it comes with its own set of questions. And this is no different. I'd say one of the biggest hurdles is, well, safety, right? I mean, we're messing around with the very system that keeps our bodies running. We have to be absolutely sure this therapy is safe over the long haul, that it's not going to cause some other problem down the line. You know what I mean?
Makes sense. You don't want to fix one thing just to break something else.
Exactly. And then there's the question of, well, can we actually make enough of this stuff? Right now, this research is still in its early stages. The study we talked about, the one with those crazy good results, it was just a handful of monkeys. To get this out to millions of people, we got to figure out how to produce this therapy on a massive scale.
Yeah.
And of course, we got to make sure it's actually affordable.
Right. Huge points, for sure. But even with all these challenges, I mean, the potential here is mind-blowing, really. Imagine a world where HIV isn't this thing people have to deal with every single day, where they don't have to worry about transmitting it as much, where the stigma starts to fade away. That's the kind of future we're talking about here.
Absolutely. And it's not just about individual lives either, although obviously that's what matters most. But think about the impact globally. If we could really get a handle on HIV, slow down the spread, save countless lives, free up healthcare resources all over the world. It's huge.
This isn't just a new treatment. It's a whole new ballgame for global health. It really is. It makes you realize that even with all the crazy stuff happening in the world, there's still so much brilliance out there, so much dedication to, like, solving problems, pushing the limit of what we thought was possible.
I couldn't have said it better myself. It's a good reminder that even when we're up against these seemingly impossible challenges, we can't underestimate the power of, you know, working together.
Yeah.
The power of science and that human drive to make things better.
Couldn't agree more. Well, folks, we've covered a lot of ground today, a lot to be hopeful for, a lot to be cautiously optimistic about, and definitely a lot to keep our eyes on. It's a good reminder that progress takes time, it takes passion, and yeah, it takes a healthy dose of curiosity too. I know I'm going to be glued to any news about this research, and I hope you will be too. Who knows what incredible breakthroughs are waiting for us just around the corner. As always, thanks for joining us on The Deep Dive. Keep those brains hungry, everybody.